Senior Pastor of Kingsway International Christian Center in London, Reverend Matthew Ashimolo, has spoken that it is a great privilege to serve people with disabilities in such an hour, and the best way to define their existence is to reach out to them. He uttered that disabled persons also play a key role in national development. Therefore, walking away from them is not an interpretation of good faith among Christians.
To bring more than 10,000 disabled people together in one place requires all kinds of skills, abilities. It's an eye-opener. It's a great privilege to be able to serve these people, to be able to patiently touch them, and to let them know that they are very important people. So it's a great joy to be here.
The Charismatic Evangelistic Ministry Center for Employment for Persons of Disability on Friday, November 15, 2019, presented numerous items to incapacitated men and women from different suburbs within and outside Kumasi at the Heroes Park. Items such as wheelchairs, beds, mattresses, clothing, food, walking sticks, and many assisting devices were donated as an act of goodwill to ease their way of life.
And so when we see people with disability, we should not shun them. We shouldn't think that they're not part of society, especially those who have children with cerebral palsy and autism. Sometimes we feel that the parents did something wrong and that is why they have children like that. It is not so. Sometimes it is not even medication. It is genetic. It can be anything. And so today we came to celebrate them. At least we gave them gifts, gave them mattresses, buckets, rice, soap, whatever. We gave them clothing. And then we are giving them medical care. It's so important. There are some disabilities that cannot be corrected. It is natural and it will remain like that. We only encourage. But those that can have medication, we are here to support them with medication. We have the 3% common fund that goes to the disabled, and then the disbursement is what we are going to look at seriously, so that at least every one of them will get a share of their common fund. And so that is so far what the ministry is doing, and in collaboration with other agencies. So we're also encouraging all churches. Government cannot do it all alone. We're encouraging churches, philanthropists, you know, people to come out, pharmaceutical agencies, and anybody who can help. Occasionally, let's meet them. My prayer is that their children would go to school. Our council chair is a lawyer. My mother was deformed. She was the first accountant at the Standard Bank Ghana Limited. And so I'm encouraging them, let the children go to school. It is not enough to beg with them to get alms. Let them go to school. And once they get to school, they wouldn't even need to assemble here and come for gestures like this. But they will also give in return to society. So my encouragement this morning is not only for us to give them things, but for us to encourage them to send their children to school to become meaningful citizens. I'm looking at the day that we'll get a disabled person be the president of this land. And I know it is possible, because it is only that the person is deformed. Apart from that, the brain and everything is working. So let's look at encouraging them and letting them be meaningful in society.
According to Pastor Ashimolo, it has come to a time where charismatic and Pentecostal churches need to come together and reliably sponsor the disabled, rather than always seeking for miracles to happen when they are being approached. He advised that until such people receive their healing, it is the mandate of the church to take care of them, to fulfill Christ's obligation.
Many times we charismatic Pentecostal churches, we move away from the disabled because we just want to see miraculous healing. But you got to also understand that some dimension of miraculous healing has to do with the sovereignty of God. Until this man receives his miraculous healing, I will take care of him. I'll give him wheelchair. I'll give him food, drink. I'll give him the buckets he needs. That is what Christ to the rural world have done. These people are part of us. They are our brothers, our sisters. What they feel, we feel. Their pain is our pain, and their joy is our joy. And it is interesting, many of them don't want to be pitied. We are not pitying them. When we were having celebration and dance, they danced more than those who had better legs. So we celebrate them today.
He expressed unhappiness and pleaded to the Ghanaian government that when organizations like Christ to the Rural World are importing items to be distributed to the needy, the tariffs attached must be considered and lessened to encourage other bodies. He disclosed that the taxes charged on items offered to the needy were huge and affected the number of items that they brought for distribution this year.
I am a foreigner on the soil of Ghana, but my only plea will be to the government of Ghana that when organizations like Christ to the Rural World is important things, that they should ask them to ask for very special certificates of exemption. They have too many track record showing that whatever they bring is not for sale. It will shock you to know that every wheelchair brought in, I think there was something like $70 tax on the wheelchair. So instead of the 1,000 wheelchair they brought in last year, they could only bring 240 this year. So we want to implore our governments to please realize the church have chosen to be the hand, the leg, the eye of both Jesus and the country to touch these people. Many of them, when they receive the things, the way they pray and appreciate, shows that they even think it's the government using the church. And they do not realize that this is totally, totally a seed of love from the body of Christ. So the government can help. Nobody is gaining anything here but giving. Let them remove tariffs on some of the things that have been given out, like wheelchairs and so on and so forth.
The former Ashanti Regional President of the Ghana Federation of Disability Organization, Mr. Prince Deborah, expressed sincere gratitude to the stakeholders for relieving the plight of persons with disability in the region. He appealed to government to solve the further delays in the common fund of the physically challenged to help them sustain living.
We thank the organizers for this program, Pastor Ransford, Ashimolowu, all the stakeholders that contributed to this program. We are grateful for what they have done for us in Ashanti region here. At least they have elevated the plight of persons with disability. Others have received some form of activities here, some form of food, items and whatever, wheelchairs and assistive devices for all our members. We appreciate it and we welcome this day in and day out, that we will always be in appreciation and pray for them that we have accepted this thing in our good faith. We appeal to government for now is that we want our common fund to be more up and coming, because the delinquency is causing a whole lot of this mess. That is why we see us here. Because most of us does not have jobs to do. So whilst they are out there, we need more. Because the discretion of the social welfare directors on distributing the items and money quota, even they will not even give you as you want. But they say it's a government money, we have to share it bit and pieces. So it's not helping. We need proper amendments on the Disability Act, on the sharing of the common fund, so that they will understand our plight and our needs, so that they will attend to us, each and everyone's needs. That is what I can say to the government.
I'm a woman.